So let's understand some applications of thermodynamics and heat transfer. What are the practical areas where we'll be applying these concepts and solve some problems or design some equipments? So obviously, as I said, thermodynamic uses or applications of heat transfer. So first would be to design equipments, or rather design equipments is the only goal of us. So what all different kinds of equipment can we design? There will be a variety of equipments. Just giving you some basic idea, the radiator we have in our car to cool the engine, that should be designed using the concepts we'll study here. Then we have cooling tower in power plant. Then we have a radiator is involved, cooling tower is involved. Then how to cool cooling a PC or laptop. So there are a lot of different things. So this involves some MHE. This is micro channel heat exchangers. Then what all things are involved while we design things? So let's see. One, we need to check the geometry. Then second, we may need to find out the material which we need to use. So we may need to cool it faster, we may need to heat it faster, so accordingly, or we may not let it heat faster, so accordingly we will choose what type of material we want. So aluminium has a higher thermal conductivity, so it will start heating up faster. So accordingly steel has, or iron has, comparatively lower thermal conductivity, so it will not heat up as faster as aluminium. So these are the basic difference. So similarly, there are a lot of other differences, and hence we use those concepts to choose the material of whatever equipment we are designing. The third is color. This is very important, and we'll go into more details of this when we are in the chapter of radiation, or someone when we are studying the heat load of a house. At that time of a car, anything like that. So whenever heat loads are included, whenever we want to calculate heat loads, wherever windows, walls or things are involved like that, the color will depend, will be a big factor, how much heat is absorbed, how much heat is reflected, and how much heating up takes place. So this is the basic glimpse for you to find and motivate you to find the applications of heat transfer. So as and when we go on studying, these things will add up to your knowledge. Thank you. And in next video, we'll look at some more an interesting thing where we'll relate between heat or heat transfer and electrical circuit. Okay.